What's good, ladies and gentlemen?
Hold on.
What's good, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy, Justbwise. And today, we're going to stop being annoyed. You just don't know the struggle today. The struggle is real, for real. This is my third time shooting this video. First time, I just didn't like how it turned out. Second time, boom, bam, bim. Beautiful. Felt like it was great. Popping into Premiere. And this is what I hear. Yeah. You hear that? Throughout the whole thing. Very annoying. Very annoying. But we're not going to stay annoyed because today we fixing problems, baby. So one of the problems we're going to fix today, it's really the only problem we're going to fix today. So the actual problem that we're going to fix today is you have a camera. You're shooting your little video, you pop it into Premiere, you got dirt on your sensor, and it's showing up in your video, you didn't notice it while you're shooting. What do you do? I'ma show you. Let's do it. Okay, so,
joking. Jeez Louise.
Okay, so if you have Adobe Premiere, then this is something that you can do fairly easily to fix any of the sensor dust that you have. And then after you do that, immediately go get your camera and clean your sensor. You shouldn't have to do this all the time. This is not something that you need to do all the time. So the reason I'm actually gonna show you this today is because, unbeknownst to me, I rented a camera and it had a dirty sensor. Didn't notice it when I'm trying to shoot the wedding that I shot, but now I'm doing some editing. I noticed it in editing, so I'm gonna fix it now. And while I was about to fix it, I was like, oh, this would be something cool for you guys to know, which is why we're doing this right now. So let's open up Premiere and hop into it. All right, so you should be able to see my clip here. Now, mind you, this sensor is very dirty. So the clip I'm gonna show you, I'm going to do a lot more work than what we're gonna show today, but I just wanna take a little bit of time to show you exactly how to do this, and that's very quick and simple to do. Let's go ahead and take a look at this brief clip. I'm gonna go ahead and blow it up full screen. And right off the bat, you can already see a bunch of sensor dust. There's here, here, some here, over here, geez Louise, here, two spots here. Good God, there's a lot of sensor dust on this. But don't mind you me. Is that even a saying, don't mind you me? Look, don't you worry your pretty little head about it. We're gonna take about that thing, right? We're gonna take about that thing. Have I ever spoke in English before? But don't you worry your pretty little head. We're gonna take care of these things quick in a jiffy. But I want to play the clip for you. All right, I feel like that's enough showing you. Okay, you see, I done messed it all up. It's completely screwed up. But it's very, very simple tip here. So all you have to do, we're on our clip here. We're gonna get an effect. So I usually come here, go to effects, and you're gonna type in dust, okay? And right here, you just take this, drag and drop it right onto your clip right there. And now you're gonna come to effect controls. Now, this effect is gonna help us to eliminate a clip. So one of the things we're gonna do is create a mask around our dust. The dust spot that we're gonna focus on is this one right here. So let's go ahead, we're gonna do a radial brush. Jeez, too much Photoshop. A radial mask. I'm just gonna move that mask over here. And we wanna make the mask just a little bit bigger than the actual spot itself. So let's do this really quickly. Bam, okay. So now I'm gonna zoom in a bit so we can see this a little more clearly. We've now drawn out our mask. Now, the next thing we wanna do is adjust our feather. And what the feather does is it kind of does a nice blending transition from where you're doing the effect to where you're just back into your normal clip. So I like to do somewhere for this size, I'll probably do somewhere about 15 to 20. But let's start off with 15. And you can see the dotted line area there is where the feather starts and ends, okay? And now what we're gonna do to actually make this effect disappear this spot is the radius. So the more you increase the radius, the more the effect goes in. So for a spot like this, a 20 should do the gif. Boom.
It's gone.
Now I know it's still a bunch of dirty spots on here and maybe distracting, but let's focus on that main one that we just did. As you can see, it's completely gone. Let's go ahead and blow this clip up again. Okay, yeah, there's other spots here. Don't get it confused. There are other spots, but we got it. Okay, so that's easy peasy lemon squeezy. That's all done. Now, I want to tell you something else. So there's, as you can see, there's two clips on here because there's another clip with the bride and groom. And in this clip, it was shot with that same camera. So we still have that spot that's going to come up here. Let me actually see where it comes up. Okay, you can see it right here. This is the spot right there. So it's here again. So now I don't want to have to do that for every clip. So here's a little tip for you. So what we're going to do is just go back to this one. And we're just actually going to eliminate this. We're going to start over from scratch. Okay. So we're just going to turn this effect off here. So we come back here to our clip. You can see our dot is back, right? What you can do to make sure you can encompass every clip that you've shot with that camera is go back here and we're going to do an adjustment layer. They got your adjustment layer. I'm going to rename this adjustment layer to, if I can type, spot removal. Okay. And then we're going to take this adjustment layer. We're going to put it right on top of the other clip and stretch it out to the same size of the clip, right? Now, everything we did on this one, we're just going to apply that to the adjustment layer. So now we're just going to do the same thing. Go to effects. If I can do my job here, go to effects, dust and scratches, drop it on the adjustment layer. We're going to do everything exactly the same. Bam, shazam, it's gone. All gone, right? Now let's come back over here to this clip. Bam, there it is. You see that? Right there, bam. Okay, so this time, all we're going to do is come over here, hit Alt, click and drag, and we can just make a duplication of this, and the spot is gone. Let's go ahead and take a look. We're going to blind ourselves from the spot removal, and you see the spot pop up and gone, pop up and gone, just like that. Easy as can be. That's something that should be done very rarely if you keep your lens. Why do I keep calling it a lens? I know it's not a lens. Trust me, I know it's not a lens. But it should be something that's done rarely because you want to keep your sensor clean so you don't have to do this extra work. Unfortunately, I didn't check. So going forward, when I rent cameras, I will be checking to make sure that the sensor is clean because this is annoying to have to do, but at least your footage is saved. You don't have to worry about everything going down. So I hope this was very helpful for you guys. If you liked the video, go ahead and let me know with a like. Also, I'm trying to do more tutorials, so if you enjoyed the tutorial here that we did today, go ahead and leave a comment down below. Let me know if you didn't like it. I don't know, like, dislike, whatever you want. Let me know how I could have made this format a little bit better for you. As always, I gave you some tools to create. Now go be great. Peace.